Some urban problems, like sky-high housing prices, are mostly a curse in wealthy cities. Other urban scourges, like filthy water and contagious disease, primarily impact the world's poorest metropolitan areas. But traffic congestion is universal. It is a challenge in London and in Dar es Salaam. Any time there are a lot of people using a small amount of space, which is to say any time you have a city, mobility is going to be a challenge. The ubiquitous problem of urban immobility may be a bit surprising. After all, urban density's ultimate benefit is to make it easier for people to physically connect with one another. Yet that is exactly why congestion is so important. It strikes at the most important function of urban density. You shouldn't expect this course to help you negotiate your morning commute any easier given the current state of transportation in your city. I figure you've got that one covered. We're going to focus on strategies to make the city as a whole more mobile. And that could only help improve your morning commute if you help in the fight to improve transportation planning for your city. Driving remains the norm in American cities, and so we're going to talk about building more roads and implementing other policies like congestion pricing that make existing roads more functional. We're also going to focus on the glories of the underappreciated bus, which can provide cheap and flexible transportation that is particularly well-suited for poorer medium-density areas. Naturally, we'll also say something about trains as well. Metro systems often seem to provide an endoskeleton for global cities. We want to ask which investments make the most sense and how to get the most out of those investments. We're going to talk a bit about what often goes wrong in transportation spending, including high costs and corruption and how to reduce those costs. Mobility is particularly tough for the world's poorest urbanites, who in cities like Sao Paulo sometimes spend over 3 hours a day stuck in traffic. So better transportation isn't just about saving you or me a few minutes each day, but it is also about ensuring that cities provide access to jobs for the most vulnerable urbanites.